Well, I was a solo act, you know, and I did the banjo kind of in my comedy show. And then I crept into it through making records and recording an album. And I remember when I recorded my first album, my agent said, "Well, do you have to go on the road?" And I said, "I do." I know there's a lot of young players who are great. Some of the acts I haven't seen, I've seen them on television. I saw Mumford & Sons on television using it, and I think it was the Avett Brothers were using it. Different types of banjo. Sometimes they use four-string banjo. Taylor Swift used a banjo guitar. You know, they're all over the place, but it's still the banjo. And I play a five-string banjo. But I think it's great because it still looks like a banjo.
And it's a little mysterious looking, and it's called clawhammer. I know that sounds like a Kama Sutra position, but it's not. It's actually a way of playing the banjo.
Yeah, I'm trying to bring the message that the banjo is not what you think it is. People, when they think of the banjo, they think of a big, loud, brassy instrument that's strummed, and it's not really at all. And it's an image that sticks in people's heads so hard, and they really have to hear the banjo, and that's melancholy, that's softer, that's really exciting, that's fast, that's slow, that's complicated.
This is an instrumental done in the clawhammer style, at least on this banjo. Called Rare Bird Alert, the title of our album. Yeah. We'll knock this off here. 1, 2, 3, 4.
You never know when that one's over.
It is.
Told me
I'm walking away.
My shrink gave his okay.
I'm walking away.
The self-help book implored me
I'm walking away. Jubilation day.